tonight on the Kristy Marie Show. Hey, Ma. We'll say hey to everybody.
Me and Krissy are happy like that again.
We rest our hearts on His promise. If you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Everybody, long time no see. I guess everybody's been wondering what in the world has happened to Kristy and her show. Lord have mercy, I don't even know where to begin. You know, after my uncle passed away and everything, things just got so busy. It's like, things just got, oh man. I don't even know how things got so busy. I know that, I know I got busy in the yard, putting down mulch everywhere, planting clover seed, a lot of yard work, planting flowers and stuff like that, and just, life gets busy, but, I'm done with all the yard work, like the big stuff, I got so much to tell y'all, got so much to show y'all, and so I don't know where to begin, I don't know where to start, I really don't, But y'all do know that Sebastian had he put down, if you saw my, my video about apologizing why I hadn't been, posting up anything about my show, he passed away, we had to have him put down. His body was starting to shut down, and he was 20 years old, so we miss him, and we've got him buried out, and buried on the other side of the yard in the back, and I got a little flag that I ordered online for his burial spot. I'll show everybody that. So I'll just start with all the little stuff I've done in the yard. We've been to Duplin Nursery and bought a bunch of flowers and everything, got a tomato bush going, and I have started something new this year, and I'm hoping that it will be successful. So far, I am very happy with the progress, as long as I can save it from all this dry weather that we've been having. I've started a garden. Yep. And I'll go over there and I'll show y'all. For the sake of time, I'll just put the camera off until I get over there on the golf cart. So I'll see everybody when I get over there to my garden. This right here is my squash. It is coming up, and I've got to do some major watering over here today, because it's got to be watered a lot. I know some of them might not be planted the way they're probably supposed to be, but this is my first time experimenting with a garden. If I have success, and so far it looks that way, I can keep them watered. And I have planted some corn, and I got to keep the squirrels away from it. There are my corn stalks right there. I've started my garden late because it was a spur of the moment thing. I thought I would just give it a try and see what happens. I have collards over here, but I'm waiting, and I don't care if they make it or not. I'm going to do them in the fall, because winter collards are a lot better than summer collards, because when the frost hits them, and it's great. I got more corn over here. Right there, 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 there. Cucumbers, I got some in a pot that I started, but then I planted some more, and just yesterday, like I said, all my stuff's gonna be coming in a little later than other people's. You know, you're really supposed to start a garden early. But anyway, I've got a cucumber planted right there. Just experimenting, seeing what all happens. If I do well this year with it, I'll probably have do the same next year and just start it at an earlier time. I'm not walking yet, it's too hot to walk. I'll come around here and show you Sebastian's little flag. It's all... wind's gotten a hold of it. Yep. He's definitely missed. We miss him a lot. Ain't really the same right now without him. And he was with us for 20 years, and that was a blessing. So, okay. So I'm just gonna ride around and share everybody. I'm trying to upgrade the yard with flowers and stuff. And this heat is just it ain't really the heat. Well, it's the heat, but really the drought. We've had a drought, and you know, like we're getting another one. Yes, we got that. My Zoom is messed up on this camera. I forgot what they're called. Hydrangea, something like that. I've got some little wildflowers planted around here that's starting to come up. We planted a bunch of gladiolas, elephant ears. A lot of them, the gladiolas, a lot of them have came up. All of them have pretty much came up. But they haven't bloomed or nothing yet. We got a tropical plant over here. It's a canna something or other. Got it there. See, there's a gladiola right there. Our biggest ones are over here by the light post. Vet sent us a card and some seeds to plant some flowers in Sebastian's memory, so I just set them out yesterday. It's disability time, which means it's the time of the month for me, blah blah. So I've really not been doing much this week. Gladiola right there. We got gladiolas everywhere. I just hope that they, you know, bloom. I mean, they came up from the ground. I just hope they bloom. I got me a handsaw, skill saw, and I made this cross right here. I did these with the thorns. Did that. That was my little project I did. The grass is, yard's filling out. I set a lot of clover, and when we had that about three days straight of rain, that's when I set it out, and a lot of it just came up like in the next day, and I was really pleased with that. Still was trying to, I think when you just pretty much summed it up to being molds that's taken over our yard, and we got to figure out a way to get rid of them. We got a crepe myrtle. We got plants on the front porch, our tomato bush right there on the right hand side, that big old tree looking thing. Yeah, we got some tomato bushes, and I'm about to run over the pampas grass here. We got a pampas grass, and I'm gonna show you something else that is not flower related, but it's super exciting, but we really don't know yet. I'm just gonna let y'all see. I mean, if y'all been on my Facebook and been following me, you know, y'all follow me, y'all know about this, but one of our hens has been sitting on eggs for about 21 days. We might be having chicks. We don't know how many. We don't even know if we're going to have any. I mean, I'm sure some are fertilized by Bob and Xander, but right now she's sitting on a ton. Too many that she can't even sit on now. And she gets really mad. Hey, trumpet, you want some baby trumps? It's about time for you to hatch some out. Oh, ha 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 ha! She's a broody hen, and she's mean. Yeah, she's a broody hen. That's why she's stealing all the eggs, even the ones that don't belong to her. We really don't know what we're going to have. Males, females, we don't know. We don't know. You know, don't count the chickens before they hatch, because that is very true. We do not. We know what we're going to have or how many. We could have one, we could have two, we could have three, we could have four, we could have five. God knows I don't want five. I'm counting. I mean, I'm hoping maybe one or two. Because I was planning on getting another one like Jake, but right now I'm not doing nothing. We've got a fig tree. Just got it. It's already got figs on it. I'm hoping that nothing eats them, because I love figs. I've got another pampas grass over here. Yeah, I know they get big. I want it. I'm kind of replacing the trees that we had here that died and they were dogwood and they eventually died. And I'm wanting to put more trees in our yard to replace the ones that we lost. So I know this can get big and I want it big. Because, you know, over here, you know, is a bad place on my building. I have to paint almost every year. And a tree right here, covering it, you know, I got this one from my neighbor. And it's got to be watered, or it's going to die. There's another gladiola I set out. Some petunias. Some of this mess is looking kind of pitiful. And these are all my wildflowers that I set out right here. This is probably boring everybody, I'm sorry. Just grass. That's grass, and that's grown since this morning. See, this gets a lot of water because it's in the soil. It's just grass I'm experimenting with. I mean, I can dig it out of there and plant whatever. My spider plant, that was from last year. It stayed in Ivy's greenhouse. I'm saving the best part for last. Well, yeah. Over here is the beginning of my mom and I's tropical paradise. I have gotten a banana tree. Actually, I've got the first one. Then over here is my second. And it's doing fairly well. Try not to let it get too much water because they told me that too much water can really damage it. This right, that right there, they're fake. These right here are fake. They're real. And I got a little plant right there. It's supposed to run up, and it's supposed to be for hummingbirds. And I got some more corn planted over in here, right in there. I don't think it's even came up yet. I'll have to look. So, you know, we got our pool. We got it set up. There it is. It, you know, it's very small. I mean, it comes up to there on me. Right there. We've been in it one time. Jessie was here, and we got in with her. And then we had a Memorial Day cookout Sunday, and I didn't get in it because I didn't feel good. And Jessie got in all day. Ivy got in it, but she said the water was super cold. But it was hot Sunday. It was hot Sunday, but it really wasn't that hot. I mean, well, it was hot, but it wasn't hot enough like today. Like, the humidity wasn't as high as it is today. But, we like it over here. Show y'all where we ended up putting it. Right here. And that's a new swing. This is our pool section. What I would love to have, if we had a truck, what I would consider doing is getting a lattice, like, you know, that over there, and putting one right here so we have a little bit more privacy. But we are more far from the road this time. I was wondering what that was, and that was, I thought it might have been a snake. We've already found two snakes. That's a fake plant. But anyway, this is our little pool area now, our little tropical paradise. My aunt gave me some palm trees to set out. I got two. It'll take a while for them to get big. But that one, you know, got that one, and then that one over there. She gave me some more. One didn't make it, and another one, it looks like it's about to die too. Just need more rain. This is our pool area. I've cleaned out underneath my building. We go inside, change in there. It's very convenient. Let me see if this corn has came up yet. I just planted it recently. So, and it probably just ain't getting enough water over here because I can't get the hose over here. I mean, I can get the hose over here, but not as far as I'd like. I'm working on my path over there. I planted clover and it was looking all pretty and green. And this lack of rain came and I don't know if it's going to make it or not. I realized that I'm going to plant any clover to fix up our yard from, I guess, the mold damage. I want to do it in the fall. Either early spring, like March, but you got to wait till the frost comes and goes. So, anyway, it is, I mean, there's a lot of places that have, that are looking better, but I ain't going to talk about my yard. You know, I've been talking about that for years, trying to just fix it up, get all these bad spots out of it. I guess I'm just obsessed with it, but I can't help it. I'm sorry. Anyway, I think that's everything I need to show you. Bob got moved to a kennel. He was so big that he was tearing up the door to this. He took the hinges off of it. Don't need water. Okay. He did that. He messed up the wire. He's so big, I mean, he can't stand up long. He flops down. He's having a time in that big old kennel I bought him. Bought one. He was too little. I mean, he was too big for it. And now, he, I don't know, he's just a big rooster. He's just humongous. Whew. I wet my hair in the pool while I go, and it's all dried off. I just jump in it. I felt like it. He can't keep water. Hey, Bob. In his bowl, he knocks it over. He gets ashes. He can't keep water in it because he gets so much of this pine shavings in it. He gets poop in it. I'm just having a time with him. I mean, I guess he just needs to be in a big old house by himself, like a big coop. I'm doing that. Okay. Then that's about all I had to share, buddy. Mama's inside cooking. I will that y'all see her, because I know y'all hadn't seen her in forever either. I hadn't even talked to Bobo in I don't know how long. I hadn't talked to nobody. I mean, not even really talked to Patty. I hadn't really talked to anybody. I just been, my mind has just been all in this yard, getting it done and getting it all pretty and stuff for the summer. So anyway, I guess they'll have to catch me up on everything. All I know is I'm just tired. This heat's getting to me, which I love it. Oh, me and Mama are going to the beach week after next, so I will be filming. But I don't know when you'll see it. It will probably not be until next season. Anyway, and that will probably be, I don't know yet, one day at a time. Anyway, that's that. I'll record Mama later. We got to go over to a neighbor's house to let the cat in because they're out of town. So anyway, I'm going to go. So I'm going to go and I'll see everybody later. We're getting ready to go over there. Let the cat in the house. And Mama's going to ride with me. Oh, Lord, my legs are asleep. Oh, we got trash now too. Hey, Ma. We'll say hey to everybody. Is it gonna snow, Mama? It's what? It's gonna snow. Is it gonna snow? Not today, it ain't. Inside it might.
My feet and knees got so cold. When they do, they ache.
You're gonna have to hold that tea. I can't sit it down. I got to come over.
Can't sit in here.
Mm-mm. Don't fit. I got tea.
Crap. Lord, I got a headache.
Okay, there's Mama. I'll record her again later.
Yeah, don't call me. I'm sorry.
You ready to go to the beach?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Oh, Mama. Tell everybody about your weight loss journey. Mama's on a diet because you think she's a diabetic.
No, I don't. So don't say that.
Your blood sugar was high when you went to the...
I know.
Oh, Mama. Oh, that's right. Nobody... if you don't follow us on Facebook... Did I not... You mean I didn't get my keys?
Oh, Lordy.
Shoot.
You ready? No, you didn't. It's something I'm sitting on.
It might be the keys. Anyway, Mama went to the doctor. She had what, a pulled muscle?
Yeah, pulled muscle. They thought it was a kidney.
We thought it was kidney stones at first. But I don't know. I think it was both. Anyway, her blood sugar was high, so she's on a diet. And she'll tell y'all how many pounds she's lost. Well, I swore I grabbed my keys. No, I didn't. She's done good. I'm very proud of her. Oh, Lordy. I got to come home and order everything. I'm tired. Still hungry. Rice-a-roni didn't go far. Tell everybody how many pounds you've lost.
I don't know. I weigh 184. That's all I know.
Well, you last
but
time
it was jumped up to 8 because I ate this weekend.
It jumped up to 8.
No, 145. 100. What was it?
You lost 11 pounds. Last time you checked, you had lost 11 pounds.
I know, but when I ate this weekend, it was it's still 184.8, but it probably gone down.
You gained?
No, I just gained. Well, not gained. I probably lost because I hadn't weighed today.
Well, she's lost 11 pounds. When was the last time you weighed?
I weighed yesterday. It was 184.
What was your starting weight?
192.
Well, that's still good.
I know.
Anyway, she's lost 11 pounds as of now. It's going to start going, the numbers are going to start falling slower now.
Probably.
What was that? The chickens, they got to have water. I got all this to do when I get home.
You don't never look at days. I'm on your
calendar. I will. It may be 8:30 when I'm in. Let me see. It's 7 now. Wait a minute.
Yeah,
it's 7 now.
Now.
Oh, no. It won't take me that long to water. I got to drag that hose around. I'm going to turn off the camera because it's going to be bumpy. This road and these... Oh, did you notice they cut the right-of-way down today?
No, I ain't noticed.
They finally did, thank goodness. Oh, that sun feels good. I am cold from being in that house.
Too, my legs are cold.
Yeah, well, my neck didn't get still. Anyway, I'm going to cut off camera. We'll see everybody later.
I know that you don't want me to touch you right now, and so I know that asking for a hug and a kiss is too much to ask.
Yeah. Sorry, I got issues, Tom. I got a lot, you know. Maybe you're right. Maybe I do need to see a shrink. I am. I really need to get going. Let me get your shirt. Here. I need to wash it. It's got my germs all over it. My flu germs.
I want you to figure out what you want while you're up there in Florida. And think of me, okay? Don't forget about me.
I won't. I really need to get going.
They let me know. You know, I don't want to keep you anymore. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. Walked out this morning and I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Times when I could not find a friend. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you, baby. One more time again now. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few... Good morning. You look, sad.
Right.
Some
and then Patty moved, messing her up and stuff. It's hard to believe I hadn't seen her since January. And I hadn't heard from her in 3 weeks. I'm taking that as a very bad sign. No, we just give her some time and, you know, that's probably the best thing to do, just give them space. I mean, that's what they want. You have to respect that. It takes for them. I promised her that I wouldn't push her. And I'm gonna keep that promise. I really screwed up. We've been broken up for about a year now, and since that day I found out all about that still bothering, I left her. Just haven't been the same, and thought that she was gonna stay and not go to Florida. She had to do what she had to do. She's got to find herself, and I understand that. And she's got to get right. But good Lord, and she's got a lot of baggage, and we don't be together, you know. She wants to be completely ready, and I understand that. But in the process, you know, I just think that she might be out there thinking that I'm not the one for her. Just plain old Jane, too goody. Since I'm a good Christian man, but I don't. I miss her like crazy. I texted her this morning and said, just want to say good morning. Try not to give up, but it's like I said. She'd been out, so she'd been down there since January, and this is summer, and she probably living all that Florida weather and stuff, and can't really blame her. I mean, never been to Florida, but I'm sure it's pretty. I still like the mountains, but and, still praying that we're meant to be it. It'll happen. God's timing. I feel like it's been forever though. Something I seen her. All I can see is her walking away. That day. It breaks my heart. I'm gonna think about it. I really hurt her. Really hurt her. And I just I need her. I love her. I never stop. And I'm glad that you forgave her. That's the best thing to do. Just forgive and forget. Well, you can forgive, you never forget, but forgiving is the best thing for everybody. Margaret's hearing is tomorrow. She's pleading guilty for something she didn't do. We have no evidence, no proof that somebody else was in them woods that night and that shot Chester. And he knows the truth, and he ain't saying nothing. She's still asleep. She had some bad dreams last night, and I was kind of with her, so I'm like exhausted right now. That poor kid. That's all I got on my mind is tomorrow. Tread it. Tomorrow's gonna be a very hard day. Krissy, she's gotta go say goodbye to her. We'll be there for her, me and you. I'm starting to think, man. She might need to be on some medication, you know, to help her deal with all this trauma. She's had a lot of trauma in her life. I'm scared for her. Sucks. I mean, I just wish we'd come with something. I've been praying hard every night. Need some patty. Oh my gosh. You're not gonna believe where she's at, Bobo. She just reached the North Carolina border. Oh my gosh. My heart's just beating, oh God. We're gonna have a heart attack. My hands are shaking like a leaf. Oh God. I don't have a seizure or anything. It ain't a heart attack, it's just excitement. Let's see, she said she doing a lot of thinking, a lot of soul searching. And there's one more thing that she has to do. She's making a quick trip to Leland to do something very important, and then she'll be heading straight to Bergall. I'm so excited, I can't believe this. Oh my God, I can't believe this. So there's a Kenyan type. Oh my goodness. Heart's like beating so bad, I'm getting like butterflies in my stomach. It's like, oh, my stomach is just got all these little butterflies in it. Oh my goodness. Okay. All right. So I was right here at your cabin, right here in Newton County. I ain't far at all. What time do you expect to be in? Because I won't be right there waiting for you. She said to give her a few hours. And she would be coming in, that she let me know when she was getting close. Gosh. Oh man. I'll be over there. I'll be there waiting. I'm so happy right now, I don't know what to do. Be careful. I love you. Will, I cannot believe this. Let's go, Uncle Tom. I'm happy for you. She said she was coming home to me, and she loved me too. Remember, we're going to take things slow. Whatever you say, pretty woman. Pretty lady. I like calling that. I like calling my little lady. Okay. I cannot believe this. This is awesome. I can't believe I'm so excited. Like, I got this urgency to pee. I got all these sensations going in my body, and I'm trying not to think the worst, and a heart attack, seizure, and you know, I'm just all excited. That's all it is. I'm sorry. I'm starting to feel kind of guilty because I know tomorrow's gonna be a hard day. No, it's okay. I'm happy for you. I really and truly am. I just that me and Krissy are happy like that. Again. Bobo, you told me not to give up. And don't know. Krissy's really not in the place for a relationship right now. But you being here for her, I know it means a lot to her. Don't give up. Just continue what you're doing, being there for her. You have her place to stay. She's safe with you. No, her number's changed, so he can't really bother her. I just worry about him finding out where she's at. I mean, he knows she's with me. I don't feel safe here. I don't feel safe anywhere. Yeah, I know. I don't want to be the rain on your parade. And I'm gonna ask you just one more time. And I want you to be completely, completely honest with me. Don't be afraid to upset me. Don't be afraid of anything. Just, I want the plain truth. I need to know if it is okay with you that me and Patty are seeing each other. I know you've forgiven her. And all that stuff is in the past and stays in the past. I don't want no awkwardness between you and her, ever. All the time, I'm happy for you. Me and Patty are, it's all behind us now. It is. I mean, it may be a little awkward at first, but I can get adjusted to it. I mean, like, just as long as you're happy. And it is. It was all Renee's fault, and that's the way I look at it. I don't even think about none of that anymore. It's all behind me. The only thing I got on my mind right now is Margaret and getting Krissy through this. And getting through tomorrow, and getting through tomorrow. That's the only thing I got on my mind now. And I want you and Patty to be happy. I mean, you know, I believe she really is a good person. I mean, you know, she just, you know, she's probably done a lot of thinking out there, and she's probably come back a completely different woman. And a woman that you want to be with. And it has nothing to do with me. And me being around Patty, like I said, it'll be a little awkward at first, but nothing that I'm not going to be able to not handle. Okay. I appreciate it. I don't want to put you in a bad spot. I don't want to put her in a bad spot. You're a good kid. To forgive someone like that, I mean, I hated her too for what she done. But when, you know, when it all comes down to it, it was all Blue Renee's fault. You know, she screwed everything up. And she's to blame for everything. But one thing that I can say is that it brought me and Patty together. You know, everything happened for a reason. You know, God works in mysterious ways all the time. And I'm hoping that Patty took my advice and got on her knees somewhere and went to some place and prayed and asked God to forgive her. Because that's one thing important, I mean. She's got to come real close to the Lord, have a relationship with Him, if we don't have a relationship. I mean, well, I'm not going to pressure about that. I'm trusting her to do that. I don't know if she will. I mean, she may already have. I don't know. But, I just, can't believe she's actually in the same state as I am right now. Wow. Can't believe it. I'm happy. I want to cry for happy tears, and I just want to jump up and down. And, she told me that, she left Florida late yesterday evening, and she wanted to drive straight here, but she was tired. She didn't want to do it herself. So she stopped to a hotel room. She crashed on the bed, didn't take a shower or nothing. And she just 2-hour nap and woke up and wanted to come straight here. She didn't want to waste no time. And she says she's ready to get home. And she ain't got no water, no electricity, nothing like that, so I'm not so sure where she's going to stay tonight until she gets all that turned back on. But I'm sure that she'll figure it out, or already has. But we're going to take things slow, you know. That's what she wants, and it's probably a good idea to start all over. And just talk all about that when she gets here. Right now, I cannot believe this. I feel like I'm dreaming. I'm just, you know, I miss everything about her, her laugh, I'm sorry. Don't give up. Bobo, don't give up. I believe that you and Krissy are meant to be together. You've known each other since y'all were kids. I mean, she was just a couple years old when you were born. And she's always been in love with you. And she still is. But right now, she's got so much on her plate with her mother. Margaret really screwed up. And she was just wanting to protect you two. Margaret's a good woman. Her heart was in the right place. But tomorrow, she's going to be in the wrong place because she's so innocent. And until we can find evidence and proof that somebody else shot him, then she's going to have to be sent to prison. I feel bad for Margaret. She ain't accepting no visitors or nothing. She's so stubborn. She's so hard-headed. I just want to shake her sometimes. But we're not going to give up. The Lord has got this. He's got his hands all over it. He's going to take care of her. He's going to take care of you. He's going to take care of Krissy. He's going to take care of me. He's going to take care of Patty. So we're all going to end up getting our happy ending sooner or later. You got to have faith, man. Faith. I love you, kid. I never imagined my life when I married Helen. I thought I had everything. I thought I had the world. Got married not too long after high school. We separated a couple times after that. It was getting hard to live with, but I loved her. And got involved with another woman that had a boy. I don't know where he's at. My deal. When your mother died, you became my son in an instant. I knew I had to take care of you for my sister's sake. And she would be so proud of you to know what you've done with yourself. I don't know how she'd be proud of me drinking and driving. But kid, can't walk because of me. The person was in the vehicle. His legs got crushed because of me. And I had to live with that. It was one mistake. You learn from it. You're doing good now. You learned your lesson, you'll be getting your license. Just a couple of months, you know. And maybe even find you a job, and anybody on young Krissy will be in a good place together, you know. Because I believe everything's going to work out. Sooner or later, everything is going to work out. It has me and Patty. Renee is off somewhere. She's not a threat anymore. And we're going to take care of Chester together. We're all going to take care of Chester. We will see that the justice gets served for whoever shot that boy. Who is that? So, don't give up. Just don't give up. God is good. And he's got a plan. You just can't see it right now. I'm not trying to preach to you, but you don't see it right now. But you will. You will. May not be today, may not be tomorrow, may not be next year. Heck, it may not even be year after next, but you'll see it. All in his time. All in his time. Thank you. It makes me feel better. It really does. I don't know what I would do without you. I think she picked the right time to come back to me, because all the trees are alive and they're not dead anymore from the winter. So bright green. Such beauty. And that's what she puts in my life. Beauty. I'm just a sappy man, I know. Man, that's really sad. Some kid some kid that was coming home this morning from church. He was walking. He was only a few blocks from his house. Got hit by a drunk driver. Oh yeah, I think I got a pop-up on that on my phone. On the news channel app I'm following. Trying to keep up with the world. Only 15. The driver was arrested and he took the kid to the hospital. And he died 3 hours later. He died 3 hours later. At the hospital due to head trauma and other complications. That's so sad. Poor kid. And that's a kid walking home from church and getting hit by a drunk driver. It's so sad. One of God's angels now. Just makes me think I could have killed people that night in that wreck. But you didn't. So don't dwell on that. You didn't. God forgives you. You're a good kid. Bring yourself down. And at least that boy, before he got killed, it was a good thing that he went to church. So sad. Just starting his life, you know. I'm sorry that had to happen to an innocent boy like that, 15 years old. Sad, man, it's sad. I don't know what I'm going to do with all my time. I'm just so antsy right now, so anxious for her just to get where she's going. I'm sitting here sweating like a mule. I can feel it all dripping down my back, down my butt. Well, I tell you, man, you need to do some better air in there. Some fans just ain't cutting it. Well, I ain't used to this. I wanted something lunch. I don't think I can get anything down my throat. My stomach, I'm so excited to get anything down my stomach. Plenty of a surprise for her. I'm not sure yet. What? I want to do something for her. Just can't believe. So he is. I'm just can't believe she's coming home to me. Wow. God is good. Thank you, boy.
God, I don't know where to start, but Tom said I should start with what's in my heart. First of all, I hope that you can forgive me all for all the bad things that I've done in my life. All the things that were so wrong in your eyes and so sinful. I'm sorry that I never, really prayed much to you in times of help and need. But I'm here now, and hope it's not too late. Don said to start with whatever's in my heart. It's just all the bad things that I've done, being a stripper and all that pornography and adultery. Breaking up so many happy people, well, they weren't really happy, but the girls didn't deserve it. Anyway, you know what I've done, and I just hope you can forgive me. And help me to put it all behind me. This was my dad's pawn. I'd do anything if he was here right now. But I'm sure he'd be disappointed in me. Knowing that his little girl turned out to be such a slut whore. But I really have changed. I have no plans. I have no plans of ever going back into that life. No plans at all. And I want to be with Tom. I want to start over with him. Make a clean start for myself and for him. I'm sure he loves it right here. He could probably do a lot of fishing here. I know he misses me. I know he loves me. I know he's so sorry. But I'm just so scared. He's going to... break my heart somehow again, I don't know. God, I hope that you can forgive me. I just feel like I can't move on. And I want to be a better person, I really do. And that's why I'm coming out here to confess my sins to you. I'm done with that old nasty life. And I hope you can forgive me. And I hope that you can lead me to making the right choices from now on, from here on out. Just make the right choices from here on out. And Dad, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I didn't turn out to be who you wanted me to be. I am a nurse now, and you'd be proud of that. Just need a sign from you, Lord. You're forgiving me, and I know that I was hurt and treated badly by that guy that I was dating. But that's not an excuse. That's not an excuse to have wanted to be a stripper and get all the attention and do all that dirty stuff that I did. That's not an excuse, so Lord, please forgive me. I've always believed in you. And you have answered a prayer or two a couple of times for me, but I'm sorry I've never really been the praying kind, but that's going to change. I'm turning to you. For any help I need. I just need to know that you've forgiven me. But Lord, I do need you in my life. I accept I've always said that you died on the cross for us. I need to start showing how much I appreciate that. I want to be more of a Christian. And if I'm going to be more of a Christian, and if I'm going to be with Tom, I got to follow you more, and I will, I promise. I hope what I said has made sense. Well, I feel better since I came out here. And I guess I can forgive myself for all the bad things that I've done and just know that I can do better. And I still have a chance to do better, and that's what I'm working on. All the trees are starting to bloom. Tom's tree of life. So peaceful out here. More peaceful than the beach. No people around. Okay, Mom. I promise you this won't be the last conversation that we have. I'll be more close with you, God, I promise.
And I can't turn back now, 'cause you brought me to the
flat tire. Yep. I don't know what it is between me and Tom. If he ain't breaking down, I'm breaking down. This is, I can't believe this. I have nothing. I have no idea how to fix a tire. I'm out here on the back road, and just like town is just a couple blocks away, and it's too hot to walk. Oh my God. And I don't want Tom to come here and change my tire. But I may just have to call him. What a wonderful way to welcome me home with a flat tire. Like him in this truck.
There's a boy walking down the road. Hmm. He knows how to change a tire. I know that I ain't got nothing to change it with, but he sees me. Maybe he can help me. We'll see.
Hey, I've got a flat tire. I don't know if you know how to change it or anything, but I gotta be somewhere in a hurry. I have nothing to change my tire with, nothing. So I mean, I don't know how much help you could be. Six blocks from my home. I just came from church. My dad probably has some stuff in his car that he can. And my dad probably has some stuff. My dad probably has some stuff in, at home that he could come and do your tire. You know, it'll be just a couple of minutes. But
okay. Well, if you're just a couple blocks away, then I can wait right here.
Ma'am, I can't promise you that I'm going to return here to the spot. I'm 15, and I feel like my life has just begun. But sadly, my life is not going to end the way I want it. But I hope the best for you.
What are you talking about?
Don't worry about what I'm saying right now. You know, you'll understand it later. I promise. Just promise. Just understand that. Don't take anything for granted. Don't. I mean, I'm not going to make it home. You don't understand. You will. I'm not going to make it home. In about 15 minutes. About 15 minutes. I'm going to get hit by a drunk driver.
You've got me really confused.
Just don't worry about it. You'll understand. I don't think that God sent me to you because of that flat tire. I think that He sent me to you to give you this. Take nothing for granted. You just get to where you need to be really quickly. My time is here. Before you need to get where you're going, your car is fine. I promise. And you have a good day and a blessed day. God loves you. Enjoy the book.
That was strange. And that tire was flat. Okay, maybe I just need sleep. I'm just exhausted, so. Probably just need sleep. That boy was right here. Maybe I didn't have a flat tire. I don't know. I need to get going where I need to be. And that's the Tom. He's waiting. Oh gosh.
Father of lies. Victor slowly became addicted to pornography. Many of his friends looked at porn, and he fell into it too. But now he understands how wrong it was. He sinned against God and crushed his wife. He's vowed to put safeguards in his life so he'll never look at it again. Yet he fears it's too late. Our enemy, the devil, presents temptation as if it's no big deal. Everyone's doing it. But the moment we catch on to his scheme, he switches gears. It is too late. You've gone too far. You're hopeless now. The enemy will say whatever it takes to destroy us as we engage in spiritual warfare. Jesus said he was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth, for there is no truth in him. Not holding to the truth, when he lies, he speaks his native language. For he is a liar and the father of lies. If the devil is a liar, then we should never listen to him. Not when he says our sin is no big deal. And not when he says we're beyond hope. May Jesus help us dismiss the evil one's words and listen to him instead. We rest our hearts on his promise. If you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. That kid really knew what I needed. God did too. Now I am more than ever ready to get the time. I don't know why that kid thinks he was going to get hit by a car. A drunk driver at that, that's so weird. I got to keep going. I am so excited. Oh my gosh, I can't believe this.
She's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head. She acts like summer and walks like rain. Reminds me that there's a time to change. Since the return of her stay on the moon, she listens like spring and she talks like June. Yeah.
assuming he's right out in that corner. There's some red stuff all over my yard. I'm just sitting in my car. Oh my God, deep breath. Butterflies in my stomach. Oh my God. I've never had this before. Well, I did when we first met. Well, I did that night, I drove all the way to his house, but this time I know that this is our beginning.
The best soy latte that you ever had in me. But tell me.